Sandham. All Gujarat Integrated Classroom.
Satellite na madhyam thi jodti kadi, etle Sandham.
My dear colleagues and students, now the topic for today's discussion is methods of teaching English. Now friends, as we all know that English is called the language of opportunity and also the language of library. Why so? Because throughout the world if you go, then we can succeed only when we have sufficient and enough knowledge of English. We should have complete command over English so that we can succeed in any sphere of life. Now, in our study time, we have to visit libraries again and again. So we need a complete command over English, be it any subject, be it economics or history or pol science or leaving aside languages, other languages, but we need a complete command over English. And when we have so much we give so much importance to English, then naturally the crucial question is how to succeed in learning English in complete manner. So as a teacher, I have been trying many methods of teaching English, and from my experience of 25 years, I can suggest a few methods. Number one, the most crucial thing about any language is its grammar. And grammar is considered as the skeleton of any language. So English grammar should be given due importance, and according to my view, a crash course or a bridge course of 2 to 3 weeks should be given in the thorough understanding of English language. The students should be made to understand the rules of grammar, and they should be given enough practice in grammar sessions. Now these units of grammar, they should be covered not in isolation, but they should be covered in practice, because the more and more they practice, the more familiar they will become with English grammar. Now after once they are acquainted with English grammar, then comes the question of vocabulary, because grammar is such a thing which is fixed. This is like fixed furniture, and there are only a few rules and regulations which have to be followed. But this is not the same case with vocabulary, because vocabulary of any language, be it English also, it is not confined to certain limits, because new words are being coined. And if you start from the age of Shakespeare even till today, there are a lot of words. Now we cannot know each and every word, but to the students, when we go in the class, what should be our approach? So from my own experience, what I have felt that when the students are new in college, initially 500 common use words should be enlisted, and these words should be of such a nature that when you speak it out, some of them should be familiar, some may sound unfamiliar also. For example, a common word is beauty. Now this word is such which I think all of the students, they are acquainted with this word beauty. Syllabus is another word. Subject is yet another word. So all these kinds of words which are of familiar usage, and in this list some words can be put which are not of familiar uses, but which can be, you know, used again and again. They are of this nature. So a list of these 400 to 500 words should be made by the teacher in the college, and to teach these words, because the primary objective is to give command of these words so that students get command over these words and he or she can use it in his own manner. So a list can be given. Now for practice, what we should do, that we can, with the help of projectors, or where projectors not available on the blackboard also, we should take initially 10 to 15 words. Now these 10 to 15 words should be illustrated in the classroom. So when these 10 words appear before the class, and this class is suppose of 60 or 70 students, you know, they should be asked to construct sentences or to frame sentences with these words. Now when they do this exercise, they will enjoy a lot and they will get much information also. For example, again this word beauty is given. So a simple student who does not have much command over English, he would write in another manner, and a student who is coming from English medium background, he may use it in literary manner. For example, when he writes, a thing of beauty is joy forever. So these 10 or 15 words at a glance, they should be asked to frame sentences. Now they should be given sufficient time. For example, for one word, they should be given at least 5 minutes. So in one lecture, these 10 to 15 words, they should be written by the students. Now when they have written all these words, when they have framed all these words, all these sentences, then they should be allowed to open their mouth, so that the variety in which all these words have been discussed or have been framed, the sentence have been framed, the others can also come to know the different uses of these words. So this process would be interesting, as well as this would be a learning process which will enlighten the students equally. Now when these words, because we have got a list of nearly 500 words, so all these 500 words in this manner, they should be revised again and again, so that their basic vocabulary is completely taken care of. Now when these words are again re-emphasized, by this the benefit is that they get a practice of writing, as well as they get a practice of speaking, the two most essential things of LSRW. When they have built enough confidence through this word exercise, now we can move one more step, and that will be like, you know, we can take pictures of different animals, different books, or different kind of pictures from any sphere of life which they are acquainted with. For example, we get a picture of jug, we get a picture of glass, common uses things, we get a picture of a projector, we can take any scenes from films, from dramas with which they are acquainted. By this, what happens, that when they see this picture, naturally something will arise in their minds, and they should be asked again to frame sentences of their own by looking at these pictures. Now when they do it, because they have got this enough practice in word formation in the, from this word, they have formed sentences as well. So when they come on the second stage and when they see these pictures, naturally they will, their mind will become active, and they will imagine of different sentences from the same picture. For example, a picture is given of, this picture is that of a bird. Now what happens? One student may write that a bird is flying in the sky. The other may write, the other may frame a sentence that the birds are innocent, and so on and so on, you know. Now when this exercise goes on, their imaginative faculty also develops, and their writing power, because writing maketh a perfect man, as Bacon has said, so their writing power also improves. Now again, after this exercise, when they have done this exercise with the help of pictures and posters, then they should be again asked to tell their sentences which they have framed in their own manner. Again, through this interaction, they will enjoy a lot, because the sentences would be of different kinds. They would be from different subjects. For example, in our general English class, we have students from economics on one hand, then we can have students from history as well. So when these students use these words, their knowledge of their own subject also improves a lot, and thus moving in this manner, they would also start developing a nice grip over their respective subject as well. Now once they got sufficient command by these methods on this vocabulary, the basic vocabulary, then some uncommon words which are used for literary purposes and which are used for the secondary level words, they can be also given in this manner, and in this process they would keep on going till they find this interesting. Now when we have seen the improvement, then we can go one more step ahead. And how it can be done? That now we can give them topics, simple topics we can give to them, and they can be asked to deliver a lecture or extempore speech on that. Now this method also works. For example, we put 10 to 15 chits in a jar, and students can be called one after the other, and each one of them by turn, you know, he or she takes up this chit and reads it alone. Then he or she should be given 5 to 10 minutes to prepare. Now when they come and open their mouth before the audience, who are their own colleagues, they are not very confident, but then they should be given a chance to deliver a speech. Initially they would hesitate because they don't have much practice, but once they come in the line, they fall in the line, then they would again start enjoying this phenomena. The simple words or simple lines which are of common use, they can be given for lecture. For example, a simple word like pollution. Now this pollution is such a thing which is concerned with the current atmosphere and current world, you know. So whatever they think, they would write in their own words, and then they would speak, and then they would read also before the audience. So by this, all these faculties, LSRW, listening, speaking, writing and reading, they would be strengthened, and this would be an interesting phenomena as well. We may not get success at first hand. Some of these students, they will not turn up, you know, initially, but then once they fall in the line, they would start enjoying it. Now, when we have brought them up to certain level, and when they have got confidence, their confidence level is quite boosted up, you know, then we can go a step ahead. And this time, what we can do, that we can make a group of two only. So if this class is that of 60 students, then what we can do, we can make a group of two each. Now these two students, they can be given a topic, and they can be asked to first write a dialogue. For example, now again, talking in this manner, these dialogue writing will be of common uses. For example, visiting a patient. One becomes a doctor, one becomes a patient, and then they would do their roles respectively. First, they should be asked to write their respective roles in coordination with each other. If one becomes doctor and second becomes patient, now doctor will write his or her roles, and the patient will also do similarly. Now when they have done their homework, and when they have written their dialogues, then they should be asked to do this role before other students. So when they perform their roles, when they speak dialogues before other their colleagues, the other students, they will again develop their confidence, and through this exercise, now the confidence level which they had attained individually, now it would be expanded. And when two of them, when they are working together, they would work with understanding, and by it a kind of social responsibility will also be there between the two, because they will try to adjust, and this adjustment is the fundamental of social life. Now when they have taken these topics, and when they have spoken their dialogues by enjoying and by laboring a lot, so by this time they have become easy, and they become easygoing. Now we can further move on, and this time we can make a group of three or four students, and the ideal strength would be 5 students. Now these groups, they are assigned a task to hold group discussions or group planning. Now how it can be done, because when they form a group of 5 students, so they can be given a common topic, that you are supposed to go on a picnic, and you plan your picnic. How will you plan your picnic? Now naturally, according to their temperament, they will assume their roles. One will become leader, one will become follower, one will become advisor, and they will just decide their roles and give new ideas to each other. For example, when we again take this topic, going on a picnic, somebody will take the charge of collecting money, some will take the charge of arranging vehicles. Now as a teacher, we ask them to write their sentences. First, when they plan to write their sentences, and then they work in isolation. When they decide their roles, that I would arrange for money, I would collect money from each other, from all the students of the class, or somebody says that I will arrange vehicles, then how he or she will move in his own manner, he or she will be made to write. And when you know this manner, again the practice of writing well will be there. Now when this happens, they will start enjoying by this time, because they become confident, they have understood each other, they have worked in a group of two and then three also, and now the group is larger, so they will start enjoying, and their command over English would be sufficient. They would again and again have the practice of English grammar, so this the knowledge of grammar would also strengthen. Now when this exercise goes on, they can be asked to hold a group discussion, because after graduation, when one goes to take admission in different colleges, you know, in many kind of courses, group discussions they are held to understand the capacity of the student in this language, how much capacity he has got. Now if we give them exercise in college life of this kind of activities, group discussion, then naturally it would be very fruitful, because they would have enough practice of grammar. Secondly, they would also try to use different words in their own manner. Now here the role of teacher becomes very important. In this manner, that teacher should have a complete watch over all the activities and over all these words which the students are using in their language. And here practice can be given of using one word in different aspects and different words in one aspect. For example, the use of noun, adjective, phrases, they can be explained to students in the proper manner by giving illustrations, by giving examples, so that they come to know of all these layers of language and they become more interested in reading. Now one more thing can be given, can be done by teacher, that he should keep on moralizing all his students again and again, so that when he patronizes his students, when he fills them with josh, when he fills them with enthusiasm, the students does not lose hope, and the teacher should not obstruct them, but in a constructive manner he should ask them to do this exercise in new manner by making lot of experiments, because the same thing can be done in different kind of ways. So students, they should be allowed to act freely, and they should not be obstructed, they should not be restricted again and again. Now the role of teacher becomes very important, because he or she should guide the students accordingly, and students will really enjoy this activity much. Now after this group discussion, group planning, they have got sufficient command over reading, writing also. But to bring them in mainstream, what can be done? One more thing in which the students lack, because you know they have attained the knowledge of basic English, but when it comes to their respective subjects, then they fail miserably. So they can be motivated to have a reading of the newspapers. So the teacher should bring any English newspaper in the class, and to give them sufficient reading practice, first the teacher should read the newspaper in a proper manner before them. And then this exercise can be assigned to the students so that they practice enough. Now again, for this exercise, they can be formed into groups, because when we make it open, then the command is not so much. So this can be practiced first initially in the groups of 3 or 4, but once they have practiced enough in these respective groups, then this exercise can be opened, and each student now is filled up with confidence. Now at this moment, proper attention should be given to his pronunciations, because by this time they have learned how to speak, they have got confidence, they have got the basic knowledge of English grammar and vocabulary also. But now this is the secondary level on which we have come. Now at the secondary level, what can be done? That the attention should be paid to their pronunciations, and the teacher should observe very minutely how the student is pronouncing different words. Now wherever any need arises, he or she should guide the students accordingly, and in such a manner that the student should not feel offended, but he should be now allowed to speak it in the proper manner. Because by experience it has come to notice that different kind of speaking mistakes, you know, they are committed because of different factors. These factors are of the group factors, caste factors, state factors, regional factors, country factors, they can be anything. Now naturally, initially they may feel offended also, but when you emphasize and re-emphasize again and again, then and keeping them in confidence, you know, because the role of the teacher is to boost up the confidence, not to lower down the confidence. So the students should be tackled very, 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 you know, calmly, and they should not be under this impression that I am being insulted before the others. Now the teacher has to be a acute observer, because you know the students come from different background, and in this mixed class where students come from English medium, Gujarati medium, cities and colleges, you know, because we have got colleges on one side, we have got Mufassil colleges, remote tribal colleges, and on the other side we have got this city colleges. Now we cannot use the same technique in all the kinds of colleges, so it depends upon the teacher how he handles or teaches the students, you know. And the basic factor is that he should boost up the confidence, he should not leave them in isolation, and the students should be allowed to work in a group. Now when they have developed a sense of teamwork, because they have got enough practice in group planning, group discussion, one more experiment can be made, and the students can be again sent, again they can be this they can be sent to different kind of people of the city or village where the students are, where this college is located. And here these persons should be informed well in advance. What I mean to say that students should take prior appointment that on this date and time we would come to meet you, so that person is ready for his interview. Now when the team of students, they are in five or six numbers, when they go to meet that person, and that person may be a government officer, government servant, a celebrity, a social worker, a teacher, professor, or a scientist, depending upon the area where this college is located. So when they go there and when they ask a different kind of questions to that person whom they have gone to meet there, they will learn the skill of asking questions, because you know that the relations which are here is they are not informal relations, they are formal relations, and the students will decide which kind of questions are to be asked and which are not to be asked. So when they work in a group and when they are deciding the nature of questions, for example, they go to meet a collector. Now they will ask about the collector's family background, where he studied, the academic qualifications which he or she has received. Then they may also ask some questions, a few questions about the district management, the kind of problems which the collector faces, and some of the personal questions can also be asked. The teacher should guide them, but he should not compel them that you ask only this kind of questions. And this kind of question should be asked in English. Now here one problem may come. The students they are asking questions in English, but that person with whom they are talking, he or she may not be well versed with English language. So that person can be given a freedom to speak in any language he likes, English or Hindi or Gujarati, as the case may be. But the students should ask only in English, and wherever a need arises, they should motivate him. They may ask such questions which may entertain him also. By this exercise, what will happen? That a kind of social or cordial relations will develop, and this impression will go that college is not a aloof place, but these college students, they are coming in contact with social persons, the persons of the society. They are having an interaction, a regular interaction with these dignitaries, with these persons who are in public life. And these persons to whom the students goes, they will also feel happy that at least somebody is coming to ask them. Now when this has happened a lot of times and students they are happy also, now different kind of competitions for students can be held in the class. For example, again they can be asked to write essays, short stories, not novel is a big thing, but short stories, simple poems, and essays on any topic. Now this time the length should be 150 words or 200 words. So when they write, after learning all these things, when they have read a lot, when they have listened a lot, when they have opened their mouth to speak, when they have spoken a lot, the last thing which comes there is writing in nutshell. Because as Francis Bacon says, that writing maketh a perfect man. So they should be asked to write a lot, and this can be done by adopting such a nice method that when we started with words, we gave them words, you write something on this word, and they framed one sentence. Again in group they wrote a few sentences as per their share, a few sentences they wrote. Now they, in past they had writing practice, they have now used enough words in their writing they are well versed with the rules of grammar, but when it comes to creative writing, the thing differs. And the again the role of teacher becomes very important, because they can be given a topic and on it they can be asked to write an essay, or if they are creative enough, if they can imagine if they can imagine, then what can be done, that they can be given a topic, a few topics can be given, of these topics can be of social concern, for example child abuse. Now this is such a topic which is concerned with the society, as we have taken one topic is pollution, then the other topic global warming, then the other topic, for example, we have got this corruption. So all the students, they can be given a list of these topics, and they should be asked to write 15 to 20 lines in their own words about any of these topics. They will take enough time. When they have taken their own time and they have written something on the given topics, again they can be made to discuss all these topics, and each one of them should read aloud whatever he or she has written. Now starting from number one student up to the last student, you know, we should give them enough time, and whatever he has composed, for example, he has composed a poem. Now this is for the first time that student has composed something, so a care should be taken that the other students don't giggle and don't make indecent comments. But a kind of discipline and decorum should be made in the class, and a good atmosphere should be kept in order to patronize the students. Now in this process, a few students would come out who would automatically say that we want to write something at our own or something of our own, and they should be given special attention by the teacher in the manner that whatever they should be given ample opportunity to come out with their own ideas. And these students are not much in number, they are hardly 20% or 25%, and since they have become active in the class and they have come up to some level, so their imaginative mind will start thinking about those topics which they have in their subconscious mind. So when they act accordingly and when they feel that they should come out with that kind of writing which satisfies their soul and which opens up their mind, they will do it. Now up till this time, these kind of exercises, the initiative was taken by teacher, but now the initiative would be taken by the students, and initially only 20% of them, nearly 20-25%, they would come out with this idea of writing something new, some uncommon things, like going on a adventurous trip. Now suppose any student take this topic, going on an adventurous trip, this is a very creative topic, and anything under the earth can be written under this topic. So if any student chooses this topic and he or she writes something fascinating, naturally, when he or she opens, he narrates it aloud, then the rest of the class would also get inspired that he or she can write, why not I? And this is a process of beginning, because college is the proper place where these imaginative faculties, they find a proper platform, and the role of the teacher becomes very again important to patronize that student, to inspire him, to guide him. Now there may come out a few students who are of this nature, that we want to work on our own poems or our own essays. So the students should give them, the teacher should guide them properly, and the guiding them in such a manner, he should guide them in such a manner that they get the proper guidance. Now here the field of research also starts, because if they get the initial training in research at this point, then they would be able to do true research later on. So if they feel like to write something of their own, which they have not found anywhere, and the teacher, when he reads their own ideas, he should not demoralize them that this is not correct. In this method, the teacher should come out with such a feeling that you may be correct, because the teacher may himself in a position that he has not read all these things himself, but the students of this category, they will come out with these ideas. Now after this, when we see this group, when we started teaching these students English, so they were on the same platform. We started with words, we gave them words, we gave them phrases, we gave them idioms, and now they have traveled a lot to come to this position. Now there, what will happen, that the students will be divided in different groups according to their capacities. So the teacher should not be under this feeling that all should learn equally, his or her attempt should be that only. But when the class is being taken for the complete 1 year, and along with covering that syllabus also, so one thing should be kept in mind, that the level of all the students is not equal. So those students who are taking interest, they should be classified in one group, and those who are performing normally, they should be again regrouped. And this kind of grouping should be based on a practical approach of the teacher. For example, those who are not performing well, now for example they are kept in group A, and accordingly those who have become excellent, they are kept in group G, from A, B, C, D, E, F, G. We divide them in 7 groups according to their performance, according to their learning capacity, according to their efficiency. And once we have classified them in the groups, the role of teacher, again, it changes, because now his or her intention should be to raise the level of that group. For example, in group A, the weakest students who don't have much background in English language, who come from humble backgrounds and all that kind of students, now they are kept. So teacher should emphasize and re-emphasize these kind of exercises in group A more, and accordingly in group B, group C. So his role should differ from group to group, because his role should differ in such a manner that the lower groups, lower in the sense the group A, who comprises of different the weakest students, they should be given more attention, they should be allowed to practice more, and they should be made to practice more and more. And again, this thing has to be kept in mind of the teacher, that the students should complete be in, they should get confidence, and they should feel enlightened, they should feel elevated. Now here the higher group students who have learned much, they should be made to help the poor students in such a manner that they live in one class but they are in different groups, but they should help each other, and they should uplift each other. So as a class, because the role of the teacher is to teach the same things to the whole class, but in this process these students have been bifurcated or trifurcated, they have been divided into different groups. Now the teacher should pay attention to the weaker ones more, and he should give more liberty to the higher groups. Now when this process goes on, the weaker groups would also improve, and a day will come when these weaker groups will also learn much from their own mistakes. They will try to labor a lot, and they will also start enjoying. And initially when they could not catch up with the other students, you know, now they will be in a role to catch up the things in the desired manner, and the teacher would feel glad when all students have come to such a level, because this is his success, and to succeed he has labored a lot in the whole process. Friends, methods can be many also, but this format which I have given to you, I have practiced, I have found it useful also, because grammar exercises, they have to be emphasized and re-emphasized, and vocabulary is such a thing which is never ending process. Even today we are learning words one after the other, this journey is never complete. So even the teachers, they remain students throughout their life, but whatever they learn, whatever words they learn new, they should go to the class and tell these new words to their students. Then again they themselves should practice, and should also make their students practice those words. There are, I have found a few magazines which are quite important. The basic role of the teacher is to inspire them and to make them read new and new things, and they should not hesitate in opening their mouth. They should be able to speak, they should be able to read, and they should be able to write in a proper manner. If a teacher can succeed up to this level, then there is no reason why a student should not feel confident, and they will not fail in any aspect of life. Because as we have been telling again and again, there in different subjects also the knowledge of English has become quite essential, and when the students are doing their graduation, post graduation in different colleges, they feel that we'll do this kind of exercise later on. But that day never comes. So college up to graduation level, this is the proper time, this is the right time. And if the teachers, if our teachers can do it properly, then there's nothing like it. The workbooks, the practice books, the grammar books, they are okay, but only the practice can make them only practice can make the students go on. So I again ask my teachers and all of you that labor is a nice thing, but when we do it in a proper direction, only we get the desired fruits. So when our students come to us from different backgrounds, from different castes, different creeds, different places, different schools, you know, and when we catch them young in first year, we should work in a systematic manner, and we should not feel that they will do it themselves, because we get less time in colleges. But whatever time we get, if we work systematically, then there's no reason that we'll fail. Thank you very much.
Sandham, All Gujarat Integrated Classroom.
Satellite na madhyam thi jodti kadi, etle Sandham.